If you don't have money, you must not have belief. It is skillful communicator. When you basing off your service, I go to the mirror. I said, what do I look like? And the mirror says, adjust this, adjust that, and that, and that, and that. But this, hey, you are the mirror of mirrors. Go to heart. So that having you look gorgeous. What a wrap God gave me. Can I give you a hug? You just look smashingly and ravishingly pretty. What a gift from heaven. Give her a hug, that's all. On her way to church, she'll be singing, praise God. Hallelujah. I'm joining this group of company of brothers who regard frowning as part of anointing. You are demon possessed. My wife tells me, she says, on the crusade ground, you're a great man of God, but in this house, you are only a husband and a father. When you walk through this door, don't act as though you're under anointing. There's no demon to cast out. What you have to be is a wife to love and children to celebrate. The Bible says you must take care of your family emotionally and physically and materially. Take create an atmosphere in that home that the Holy Ghost can walk there. Amen.
Amen.
Our sister, turn back to her. You must learn how to submit to your husband. Because daily submission leads to daily protection. Nothing is answer a man like a humble wife. A woman who wants to show how intelligent she is more than her husband will soon have had more pleasure as her companion. Be humble, be submissive, and you disarm your husband. But you make him a slave without the man knowing he's your slave. We'll take one more play. Let's go to the book of Job. The book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 22. The book of Joel, chapter 12, verse 22. Let's take those two places. I've been spending time talking about what you must hunger after. Whatever your heart desires will determine what you become in life. We'll take those two, we'll take to go to number two. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The Bible says, this great God revealed the deep. How do I say it? There is nothing makes a preacher a great preacher if it's a man of imagination. Nothing makes a man a great man like being a man of imagination. I want to say, any man of imagination, don't count him out. Any woman of imagination, don't count her out. Now the man, even if your wife earns more than you do, that's your own money. Tell her how much you love her. And if you are intelligent and wise, you don't have to go for a wife. And that's when you can. The worst thing is to have no money and not know how to communicate skillfully. Are you hearing me? If you don't have money, you must not have belief. A skillful communicator. When you basing off your service, I go to the mirror. I said, what do I look like? And the mirror says, adjust this, adjust that, and that, and that, and that. But this, hey, you are the mirror of mirrors. Go to heart, so that having you look gorgeous. What a wrap God gave me. Can I give you a hug? You just look smashingly and ravishingly pretty. What a gift from heaven. Give her a hug, that's all. On her way to church, she'll be singing, praise God.
Hallelujah.
lack of anointing. You are demon possessed. My wife tells me, she says, on the crusade ground, you're a great man of God, but in this house, you are only a husband and a father. When you walk through this door, don't act as though you're under anointing. There's no demon to cast out. What you have to be is a wife to love and children to celebrate. The Bible says you must take care of the family emotionally and physically and materially. Take the great and atmosphere in that home that the Holy Ghost can walk there. Amen.
Amen.
Well, sister, from back to her. You must learn how to submit to your husband. Because daily submission leads to daily protection. Nothing is answered to a man like the humble wife. A woman who wants to show how intelligent she is more than her husband will soon have had more pleasure as her companion. Be humble, be submissive, and you will disarm your husband. But you make him a slave without a man knowing he's your slave. Okay, we will take one more play. Let's go to the book of Job, the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 22. The book of Job, chapter 12, verse 22. Let's take those two places. I've been spending time talking about what you must hunger after. Whatever your heart desires will determine what you become in life. We'll take those two, then we'll take to go to number two. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The Bible says, this death goes revealed to deep. How do I say it? There is nothing makes a preacher a great preacher if it's a man of imagination. Nothing makes a man a great man like being a man of imagination. I want to say, any man of imagination, don't count him out. Any woman of imagination, don't count her out. Even if your wife earns more than you do, that's your own money. You tell her how much you love her. And if you're intelligent and wise, you learn how to go from the wife. And that's when you can. The worst thing in life is to have no money and not know how to communicate skillfully. Emotionally and physically and materially. can have those faith that go, that the Holy Ghost can walk there. Amen. But sister, come back to her. You must learn how to submit to your husband. Because daily submission leads to daily protection. Nothing is answered to a man like the humble wife. A woman who wants to show how intelligent she is, not as her husband, will soon have had more pleasure as her companion. Be humble, be submissive, and you disarm your husband. But you make him a slave without the man knowing he's your slave. Okay. We will take one more play. Let's go to the book of Job, the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 22. The book of Joel, chapter 12, verse 22. Let's take those two places. I've been spending time talking about what you must hunger after. Whatever your heart desires will determine what you become in life. We'll take those two, then we'll take to go to number two. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The Bible says, this death goes revealed to deep. How do I say it? There is nothing makes a preacher a great preacher if it's a man of imagination. Nothing makes a man a great man like being a man of imagination. I want to say, any man of imagination, don't count him out. Any woman of imagination, don't count her out. Even if your wife earns more than you do, that's a good money. Tell her how much you love her. And if you're intelligent and wise, you learn how to go from the wife. And that's when you can. The worst thing is to have no money and not know how to communicate skillfully. You must not have to be a skillful communicator. When you dress it up for service and go to the mirror and say, what do I look like? And the mirror says, I just this, I just that, and that, and that, and that, was this. Hey, you are the mirror of mirrors. Go to her, say, that darling, you look gorgeous. What a wrong God gave me. Can I give you a hug? You just look smashing and ravishing the preacher. What a gift from heaven. Give her a hug, that's all. On her way to church, she'll be singing, praise God, hallelujah. I'm joining this group of brothers who regard frowning as part of anointing. You are demon possessed. My wife tells me, she says, on the crusade ground, you're a great man of God, but in this house, you are only a husband and a father. When you walk through this door, don't act as though you are under anointing. There's no demon to cast out. What you have to be is a wife to love and children to celebrate. The Bible says you must take care of your family emotionally and physically and materially. Take the great and atmosphere that whole, that the Holy Ghost can walk there. Amen. But sister, come back to her. You must learn how to submit to your husband. Because daily submission leads to daily protection. Nothing is answered man like the humble wife. A woman who wants to show how intelligent she is, not as her husband, will soon have had more pleasure as her companion.